France, meantime, is making moves against Islamic extremists in the wake of last week's Paris attacks. Francois Hollande is sending an aircraft carrier to the Middle East to join the U.S.-led coalition against ISIS. The French government ordered a crackdown on anti-Semitism and other hate speech, already rounding up several dozen people on related charges. Charlie Hebdo's first issue since the attack sold out before dawn. Another print run of some 2 million more copies is planned. Now let's bring in the French ambassador to the U.S., Gerard Araud. Mr. Ambassador, thank you so much for being here.
Good evening.
Let's start with the latest on this investigation. There is apparently a new suspect who has been identified, an accomplice.
Yes, because the problem we have now is that it's obvious that these two killers or three killers were supported by a network. So we have to dismantle the network. And apparently we have first identified one member of the network. And secondly, we know now from where the weapons are coming. Apparently they were bought in Brussels, in the neighborhood of the railway station, where there is a lot of trafficking. You know, because now weapons are in Europe are coming from the Balkans. So you have a lot of Kalashnikov, unfortunately, which are that you can buy now for a few thousand euros.
The video we saw today was Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula taking credit for this attack. We know that both of the brothers, the Karachi brothers, traveled out of the country to Yemen, and there was some kind of coordination, according to intelligence officials. What do you know about the tie to Al-Qaeda?
That's one of the big questions that we have to answer, because there are two main possibilities. One is that Al-Qaeda is the sponsor. You know, they simply said, do and kill these guys. And or the other one would be that Al-Qaeda is the operational commander of the operation. And it makes a lot of difference, because if we discover that Al-Qaeda can organize such an attack from the Yemen, it would be very serious. And it may be the case, because the attack was very professional. It was not lone wolves, the way, you know, we were expecting. And they behave as a military commando. So it's really very worrying. So the investigation is conducted precisely on this point.
So just over the few hours, we have another person being named here, but there are other people being looked for.
Of course.
Tied to this cell.
Yeah. You know, it's a network. So now we have to look for the people. Some names are floating around. We know so that the wife of Koulibaly, you know, the killer of the grocery, the kosher grocery shop, has succeeded to go to Syria the day before. Apparently, she crossed the border the day before the attack, and she was with somebody that we have identified and which is linked also to this to the radicals. So again, we are in the investigation.
I want to, you know, the world has obviously reacted to these attacks. I want you to take a listen to the Turkish president and his comments and have you react.
The hypocrisy of the West is obvious. As Muslims, we never stood up for terrorism. We never stood up for massacres. But it is racism, hatred, and Islamophobia that lies beneath these massacres. Officials of the countries where our mosques are attacked should take measures against these incidents. These are provocations.
Your reaction to that?
Well, I don't, you know, I'm only an ambassador. I don't react to a president. What I want to say is, as the French Prime Minister has said, we are at war, and we are at war with radical Islam. It means that right now that Islam, and in a sense Muslims are the first victims, but Islam is breeding, radicalism, which is quite dangerous for everybody. So I think that in the coming weeks or the coming months, we have to define a global strategy, and a part of the strategy is to work with the Muslim countries. They have to do their part of the job.
Are you surprised by the reluctance of the Obama administration to use the word radical Islam?
You know, Everybody has its own sensitivity. You know, really, that's the political life in the U.S. It's not the same thing that the political life in France. The fact is, in France, is that, as we have known, an attack which was really an attack by Islamists. And it was not only an attack only by Islamists, but it was an attack on the Western democratic values. So that's what led our government to define the war, to say, now it's clear what we have. On one side, radical Islamist, on the other side, democracy.
I have heard you and other French officials deal with the unity march and the lack of a high-profile U.S. official. I'm not going to ask you about that, but I do want to ask you about the challenges uniquely to France, with some 6 million Muslims, and this question about assimilation and multiculturalism and what's happening in your country and the challenge that that involves.
Well, again, first, in a sense, it's not only a French challenge, it's an European challenge. Why the French, in a sense, we are on the forefront? It's because we have the first Jewish community out of the U.S., and we have the first Muslim community in Europe. So, and we are, that's the reason, in a sense, why we are the first truck. But all European countries are threatened. You know, I think it was yesterday or a few days ago, the head of the British MI5 said an attack against London is, I quote, highly likely. So we are, all of us, we have the same problem. We have a problem of assimilation of immigrants, and most of the immigrants in Europe are Muslims. But it's not because you are disadvantaged in a society that you become a killer. The fact is that we have an integration problem, and there is also the problem of radical Islam. And that's not the same, you know, really. It's one may be the breeding ground for the other.
Mr. Ambassador, we appreciate your time today.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.